Hi friends, this is the Smart XLR. This video will be showing you how to use the match function. So the match function is like the same which we use for COUNTIF to find the common values and non-common values. So for COUNTIF with not equal to or without any values, if you type, you will get the common values, and if you make COUNTIF is not equal to 0 or equal to 0, then you will find a difference in both set and com, and then if you want by common, then it will be not less than equal to 0. So the same formulas will be applying here, and we'll be finding match for common items and is not match for non-common items. So let's start it. So this is the data. I have two set of data, so I want to find the common items now. So first select the data. Go to home, conditional formatting, new rules. I can go from here also, but you can go directly here, new rules. Use formula to determine which cells to format. And here you can write the match formula. It will be like MACH. So now you have to look at the lookup value. So the lookup value will be in the same here. So this is going to be my lookup value. I'll be hitting F4 two times. So it's a column wise reference and comma, and this is going to be my data. If I select data in this way, or if I make a range for this data, it will be a dynamic data. Sorry, it will be a static data. So anything if I add, it will not be affected. But if I want a dynamic data, I have to select the whole set of bunch in this way and have to do nothing over here for the dynamic data, because it's going to take the whole column. So we put in a comma, and I want an exact match. There is no screen tip, so I have already managed to get the screen tips on the top. So just like lookup value, lookup array, and exact match. So zero for the exact match. So tapping zero and closing the parenthesis, formatting the cells, and doing okay and okay. So these are the items which are common in both sides. So if I want to see, I can just BT, if I just remove this. So this double over here, so I have to remove this also. So now you can see, it has gone. So now if you do Control Z, and if I do Control Z, it is here. So if I want to make some changes, if I want to hit backspace, you can see it has gone. So now if I do Control Z, automatically it gets highlighted. So the same way I'll be doing for here, but you have to see that there are not more than two or three double values, because now if you have seen this, so there are two times over here, so you have to check it very carefully. So if you want to do for this value or this side also, you have to select the data. Once you select the data completely, go to conditional formatting, new rules, use formula, and here you are typing the same thing, MATH. Open the parenthesis. The lookup value will be the same value over here. So we'll be hitting F4 1, 2, and 3, 2 times, comma. The lookup value will be the same if you want to select for dynamic or static, and if you select the whole bunch for a dynamic database, comma 0 for the exact match, close the parenthesis, format cells, give a color and do okay. So this is for the common items. So if you want, you can do a check over here, BTU is there. So if I remove this, see, you can see both sides the BTU has been vanished. If you want to remove, so you can see it's vanished here. But if you have to check properly, if there is more than two, it will not be going unless you remove all the sectors. So now if I do Control Z, it will be back. Now if you want to see, you can see that these are the common values. Now if you want to find a difference here, so what should I do? So I'll be doing the same thing. I'll go to the same area, conditional formatting, manage rules. Now I'll be hit editing this, and just I'll be typing isna. ISNA, open parenthesis. So we have to hit one more parenthesis over here. So parenthesis open here will be closing here. And I'll be doing OK. By hitting this edit, same thing. Isna, open the parenthesis and close the parenthesis here. So now you can see the items which are highlighted automatically will be changing its position to non-highlighting, and the non-highlighting will be highlighted. So you have to do is OK and OK. So you can see the items I have been changed now. So these are the non-common items. So if you want to have a check, you can also do a check on this. So if you want, you can copy this. Control C. You can paste it over here. So it has, the highlighting has gone. Similar way, you can copy any item over here from here. Control C. You can paste it anywhere here. So you can see it is not highlighted. So this is the way, very simple way for match isna. So in the next video, I'll be showing you for a group of for a whole set of data is how to do this. Please watch my other videos in counting. Also, I have made more than 10 videos on different sort scenarios, but here I'll not be doing all the videos, but I just have managed to do isna match.